Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. She's a diva in every sense of the word, an on-screen gem and an advocate for those in the social and entertainment sphere.
And she's no stranger to the circle, and she returns today to chat about her upcoming small screen projects and riveting short film, First Day Back. Take a look.
Why, we gotta settle down. They in here doing a story about us. This is how we feel.
You know, actually, I think you have a good point. This is not the best time.
No. I think we should let them speak. Let them say how they really feel.
Oh, yes, let them say what they really feel. Please welcome the beautiful and the incomparable Sheryl Lee Rouse.
Oh.
Yes! Yes!
Oh, my. Come on
you,
now.
Hello,
oh, darling. Man. Is that man being good to you?
Always.
All right now. There you go.
Honey.
Yes.
Are you just going to come to the circle looking all fine like this?
Yes. There is no other way to do it.
You are doing it well.
Thank you very much. I say to myself, in all of my years, it is my duty to maintain the beauty.
Yes.
Thank you.
I'm going to have to steal that.
That's all right.
Just let her borrow it.
Thank you. Go on.
Speaking of stealing your stuff, you know, like we always say, we troll everybody's pages.
Yes.
On Instagram.
Okay.
And I want to quote you properly. You said, you were looking at your cell phone and you said, you wouldn't let this happen to your phone. Don't let it happen to you either. And you were talking about the dying battery on your phone. So how do you ensure self-care as a priority?
You got to live right. You got to be right. You got to be right. You got to be right. And it's so simple, it's complicated for people. And I say the way you treat yourself, see, that's how you treat everybody else. You're short with yourself. You don't take care of yourself. You're short with other people. You don't take care of other people. I want a life of abundance. You know that prayer of Jabez, where we say, increase, increase, Father?
Yes.
I'm praying for the increase of good. And as I increase in good for myself, I'm able to share it more with other people.
Yeah.
So you got to live good. You got to live right and do everybody right. Isn't that a famous poem? I'm going to stay on the front line and I'm gonna treat everybody right.
I love that. But I also love what we just saw here in our side. So your short film, First Day Back.
First Day Back.
Why was it so important for you to bring this to the forefront, and what resonated most with you?
You know something, with my foundation, the Diva Foundation, divinely inspired, victoriously alive, we do much more than help broke down divas with their wig, weave, weapon, wardrobe problems. You know, we are all about maintaining the good in our lives. Like I say, divinely inspired, victoriously alive. And we, you know, we started out around HIV and AIDS. We have now grown to cover other life-threatening diseases. I chose to include in that gun violence because too many of us, especially our young people, are dying every day by gun violence, and they are dying in silence, and we wanted to really shed a light on that.
That's
a wonderful young director, Deshaun Plyer, you know, got a great script with Sade, and my son, Etienne Maurice, saw it, and he himself has his own story about gun violence.
And we're gonna hear more about him and you.
Yes.
So stick around, we have much more of Ms. Sheryl Lee Rouse, and we'll be doing with her son, and he's gonna star in and he helped produce First Day Back. So stay with us.
We're back with the diva herself, Sheryl Lee Rouse, and her son, actor and film producer Etienne Maurice. Welcome to Sister Circle Live. We are so happy to have you.
Glad to be here.
Yes.
I'm just gonna jump right into you, Etienne. So you are producing this movie.
Yes, I'm
and you're also acting in this movie.
Yes.
So what kind of responsibility was that on you to have to do the acting and the producing for this movie?
Well, you know, I thought this story was a very important story to tell in regards to gun violence and how kids are affected by gun violence. You know, me being a survivor to gun violence, you know, I thought what better way to tell the story than to be able to be in front of the camera, but also behind the camera. You know, I used my connections and I called my Auntie Loretta Devine,
Auntie.
You know, Aisha Hines, you know, Cornelius Smith Jr., you know, JVC, Leslie, these are all the stars that are in the film. And I was like, you have to be a part of this. And they were for it. You know?
Now, you recently just touched a little bit on your personal experience. Mm-hmm. You were a victim of gun violence. You were shot 3 times yourself in Philadelphia. Yeah. How did you channel your pain into the movie to actually give the real feeling of what truly happened?
Well, you know, I had to, you know, turn my trauma into triumph, you know, and I had to utilize, you know, my art to really bring that to the forefront. And, you know, it affects me till this day. You know, something that I think about every day. You know, my character, Mr. Harris, in the film is suffering from post-traumatic stress, and he's a teacher. And he's kind of battling with that in front of his students.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, in my life, I had to deal with having to go back to school, you know, a month after I got shot. But I was determined to graduate. Yes, I wasn't going to let that stop me, you know, and that's the important thing.
You all just showed a picture, and, you know, you see the bruising over his right eye, and his left eye, you know, and it's so interesting. That right there, the police detectives didn't tell me until we were after court and everything. They said, Miss Ralph, they told me he had been pistol whipped. Oh. They said that was the 3rd gunshot missing your son. Oh. So every time when I look at my son, I say, I know what a miracle looks like, because my son is still here.
Absolutely. That had to be a challenging day for you.
Girl, please.
You got that phone call.
Yeah, how was that phone call for you?
That morning when I got that phone call, because he didn't want to tell me, so he had his he called his sister in California to call me in Philadelphia, because I was there with my husband, and I heard Etienne had been shot 3 times.
I cannot imagine.
My world stopped. I don't remember having the phone in my hands. All I remember is a hot sensation. Mm. I was just peeing on myself.
Ooh, wow.
It was just over, because I knew they were going to tell me he was dead.
Oh my God. Thank you guys for coming and telling this compelling story.
Thank you.
Thank you both for joining us today. First Day Back is coming soon, so be on the lookout, and you can keep up with Sheryl and Etienne on social media.
Absolutely. Yes. We'll be screening at Bronze Lens this weekend, T-Neck International Film Festival in November.
And follow us on Instagram, First Day Back Film.
And the conversations continue on all social media platforms at CircleTV.com.